The book of Hebrews, chapter. Very important. Chapter 13, verse 15. Hebrews 13, verse 15. By him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is, the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. So our thanksgiving is a type of sacrifice. Is a type of sacrifice. Like in the Old Testament, their worship and their walk with God was filled with so many rituals of sacrifices. There were daily sacrifices. There were monthly sacrifices. There were annual sacrifices. There were many sacrifices that really accompanied their worship and their walk with God. In the New Testament, of course, we do not offer animals. But it says, we offer sacrifice of praise to God continually, and that is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. Our praise and our thanksgiving is a type of sacrifice. It's not just a song. Sometimes we reduce our praise and our thanksgiving to just something just like a mere song, a simple song. It is not just a song. He says it is a type of sacrifice. You need to have the picture of an altar that was burning with animals. And therefore, when we come to the Lord with praise and thanksgiving, similarly, it approaches the throne of God with the same kind of an approach as a sweet aroma, as we do it from the depth of our hearts. Very cognizant that we are, because God has made us to be, acknowledging him for all that he is and all that he has done. That there is nothing in our lives that has just happened by coincidence. Anything good in our lives, it must be God at work in the happening. Therefore, we are not taking for granted. We need to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to our God. And therefore, today, as we begin this great journey of this prayer week, as we begin to command the month of November, very important month for the sons and daughters and everyone that believes in this altar, the month of November has been declared by the leading of God as a continuation. That means we are going to be empowered all the more for kingdom prosperity. It's going to be a very unique season. For to us, November is not just days and nights and hours and minutes and weeks. It's a season. And for all that the Lord has done, look at this. If you look back all the way from January and even beyond, before 2020, you can see the faithfulness of the Lord. See the faithfulness of the Lord. See the goodness of the Lord. See what God has done. People have died. We are here. We are still alive. And he says, if you have breath, you qualify to give thanks to God. See how God has rescued you and seen you through. Maybe everything has not happened as you desired, but all the same, you can attest that if God were not on your side, by now you have been swallowed by the enemy. Therefore, let's look back and give thanks, and our thanksgiving as a sacrifice of appreciation, of honor, of regard, of acknowledgement that, Lord, you've been so good to us. For the Lord exempting us. You see, one of the things you should know, that every minute the devil is planning how to kill you and me, because that is his mission. And you know, when we go to sleep, the devil does not sleep. He's a spirit. And his mission is to steal, kill, and destroy. His plan has ever been on how to kill you. That you are still alive, it shows that God prevented the devil from killing us. Please, for the gift of life this far, the whole year until the 11th month, the year 2020, even though you are in the hospital bed and you are listening right now, the reason why you have not transitioned to the mortuary is the hand of God upon your life. Even though you may have lost somebody in your life, God is the reason why you have not lost everybody in your family. Therefore, he deserves all the praise. Let's put up a sacrifice of thanksgiving and picture it. You have an altar there, you have an animal there, and the fire underneath, and it is burning towards heaven. Let your thanksgiving go that way. For the gift of life, for the deliverance that God has given us continually, when the enemy came in like a flood, we lift up our voices to him. When you were sick, the Lord healed you. When you were just about to die in a road, the Lord delivered you. When robbers were about to kill you, the Lord delivered you. When some fire would have taken away your life, God delivered you. When some evil happenings were glaring at you to take away your life, he delivered you. So let us not forget that. We lift up our voices for the Lord's deliverance the whole of this year until the month of November, that day. Father, we are so grateful. We can never forget your faithfulness. You've been so good to us. You've been so gracious to us. You have redeemed us from the schemes of the enemy. Almighty God, fighting our battles, some that we'll never know. Almighty God, you have delivered us many times, day by day, night by night. Almighty God, when the enemy came in like a flood, you lifted up a standard against him. Almighty God, receive all the glory. We praise your name and acknowledge your majesty, your mighty hand upon our lives. We are because you have sustained us. We went to sleep and woke, for you, Lord, did sustain us. Almighty God, you have not allowed us to fall to the plans of the enemy. You have watched over our souls day by day. We went out and came in because you, Lord, your mighty hand was upon us. We glorify you. Receive our heartfelt praise. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you for the healing of the sick. Thank you for delivering us from that death that was planned against our life. Be glorified, King of Kings. Be glorified, Lord of Lords. In you we live, we move, and have our being. You have sustained us, O King. Every breath we breathe, O God, we breathe by you. Almighty God, we worship you, we magnify you. Thank you, Lord, for sending your angels to deliver us from the evils. Bashe, Kata, Bateladaya. Receive all the praise. Receive all the glory. Receive adoration. Receive all the honor. Bashe, La Brase, Telebredia. Thank you, Jesus. You have done all things well. And we give you all the praise. We need to appreciate the Lord wherever you are. Give him all the glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And what more shall we say? That you have given us the Holy Spirit as a deposit guarantee that we belong to you. You have sealed us with your Spirit. You know, he says that he has sealed us with the Holy Spirit, that we belong to him. Ephesians 4 verse 30. That you belong to Jesus. If you are born again, the Spirit of the Lord in your life is a seal that you belong to him. Therefore, the devils, they have no claim. And if they try to make any claim, it's illegitimate. If the devil tries to claim anything in your life, it is illegal. It's a trespass. Is an offense. The Holy Spirit in our lives has been our seal that we belong to God unto the day of redemption. is the greatest gift, and much more the mystery that he lives inside of us, that the Holy Spirit lives inside of us. God himself, he lives inside of us. So we are not trying to call him from a mountain somewhere. We are not trying to commune with God who is astronomical miles physical. No, he is living inside of us. If you are born again, you have the Holy Spirit of God. Please, once again, very aware of this very fact, the greatest privilege that God would live inside of us to help us and so that to empower us. Lift up your voice once again to give him thanks. Remember, he is our helper. He's the one that has helped us this far. He's the one that will carry us the month of November, the month of December, 2021 and beyond. Let's lift up our voices and give thanks to God for the Holy Spirit in our lives. Oh yes, we are so grateful, Lord. We do not take it for granted, oh Lord. Oh yes, it is not our working. It is not our plan. But you're working in our lives. We are so grateful, oh God, that you will redeem us to yourself, and that much more, Lord, you will seal us as belonging, as your very own possession, and giving us the seal of yourself by the Holy Spirit. And that now, Lord, you live inside of us, God living inside of a man, the creator living inside of the creation, the divinity living inside of humanity. We are so grateful, oh dear Father, you live inside of us to help us. You have helped us, oh God, in many ways. Some of them we will never quantify or articulate in any way. We are very grateful, dear Lord. We are very grateful, King. Receive all the praise. Receive all the glory. Receive all the honor. Receive adoration. Receive all the praise. Almighty God, we acknowledge, oh Lord, that this is a great mystery. It's a great honor, a great privilege that God, you have chosen even to live inside of us, and you have given us the seal that today we belong to you. That's why we have come this far, all the way from January, because you, Spirit of God, you have helped us day by day, week by week, minute by minute, hour by hour. We thank you and glorify your name. Thank you for the ministry and the mystery of the Holy Spirit in our lives. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Let's put our hands together again for Jesus. Kama unamaanisha, angalia uaminifu wake, upendo wake, fadhili zake. Tumwambie kutoka kwa ndani ya moyo wetu. Relationship with an imperfect human. And much more, God has not waited for us to be perfect. But through his perfection, he has decided to just declare us perfect. That's why he has borne with us in our weaknesses, in our imperfections, even our sins. He did not even wait for us to seek him. He the one that came to seek us. Because when we were lost in sin, Christ died for us. There is no man that can seek God if God does not seek man. What am I bringing to us? I want you to see a side of God that does everything before he can ask us to do anything. He's the one that qualifies us because we are obviously not qualifiable to meet his standards. He does not even deal with us directly according to our actions. That's why he brought Jesus Christ, so that he does not look at us directly. Anytime he wants to look at us, he will always do so through Jesus Christ, his perfect son, so that he can perfect we, his imperfect sons. In other words, if God was going to look at you directly according to your actions, there was no way for you to stand a minute before him. I want us to give thanks to God. How many times you have faltered here and there? How many times you have even fallen in sin? How many times we have even disobeyed him? How many times we have even gone contrary to his will? I want us to just thank him that the Lord has been this patient with us. That the Lord has been this merciful to us. That the Lord has been this gracious to us. Because the only thing we can say there is grace has been so gracious to us. Oh yes, we lift up our voices. That even when we fell, he kept saying, my arms are outstretched. That you can always come back. That you can always come back. That you should come back. Because if you confess your sins, he's faithful and just to forgive all your unrighteousness. Look at that side of God. There is no other person. Look at that. He does not wait for our perfection. He trusts his perfection in our lives. I want us to lift up our hands to God for his faithfulness and that kind of side of God that is so merciful, that is so loving, that is so gracious, that there is, he has done everything even when we failed short. Let's lift up our hands and glorify him and give him thanks. And give him thanks. And give him thanks. And give him thanks. Oh yes, Almighty God, we stand in your presence not because we qualify by our own strength, abilities, or religiosity or spirituality, but Lord, we stand before you because you, Lord, you have made us to stand before you by your perfection, Almighty Lord. We thank you for your unfailing mercy, unfailing love, the grace that, Lord, you are not waiting for us, but Lord, you are coming down. Oh, yes. And you are stretched, outstretched hands, ever receiving us, ever receiving us, ever receiving us. We thank you for your amazing love. We thank you, Lord, for your grace. We thank you, Lord, for your mercy. Your mercy, your grace, unfailing love. Oh, Shadabagadabaka, Rekatabayataladea. We thank you and glorify your name. We should have been destroyed by now, but your grace, but your mercy, your unfailing love. Oh, Yadagadaba, your sacrifice of Jesus. Father, we thank you that now we can always stand in your throne confidently and boldly, having this assurance that Jesus has perfected us by his perfection. We thank you and glorify your name. Receive our heartfelt praise. Be glorified. You have forgiven our iniquities. Almighty God, you have not counted on our faults. Baru Sataya, Rekatabaka, O Shadabalakaya. Even when we disobeyed you, even when we went contrary to your will, you have always waited for us to come back. And you have kept calling, and you have kept stretching your hand and showing us your mercy and your loving kindness. Almighty God, we are so grateful, Lord. Thank you for the blood of Jesus that is ever speaking mercy. Oh, Shandabalakataya, we bless your name. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We are grateful. We bring a sacrifice of thanksgiving for your mercy, for your loving kindness, Almighty God, for your love, for your grace. Receive the praise, receive adoration, receive all the honor.
What a mighty God. Oh, Rabahanda Dadaya. Rakata Bayachia. Barata Lakosa. In Jesus' greatest mighty name. Oh, yes. What a great love. That you, Lord, you should die for us. We are so grateful. Mighty God, we are so grateful that you have done all things well. It's marvelous in our sight. Romans chapter 8, verse 32. Romans 8, 32. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not also with him also freely give us all things? Give us all things. That is to say, when God gave us Jesus, he gave us all things. All things consist and exist in Christ. All things are in him. Because it has delighted God the Father that all things should be in Christ, including his fullness. All things that we have received and all things that we are looking for, whatever, whether spiritual, material, financial, job, career, business, when he gave us Jesus, he gave us all things. That he did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, not even some of us. How shall he not also freely, with him also, give us, you know, freely all things? I want us to make acknowledgement. Whether at the moment you have all things, or still there are things you are still desiring from him. Because even what we are asking from him, he has given us. It is as somehow we have not received. If whatever we are even asking God to give us, he has already given us when he gave us Jesus. It is as somehow either we have not known or we have not received. So we are lifting up our hands in thanksgiving. For giving us all things in Christ. Make that acknowledgement as you give thanks to him. Today is a Thanksgiving Monday, Tuesday. Yes, go ahead and give him thanks and give him thanks and give him thanks that he has given us all things in Christ Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you that in Christ Jesus you have given us all things. The things that we have received now and the things that we are yet to receive. Oh, mighty Lord, you have already given us all things. Spiritual, physical, financial, family, job, career, dreams, vision, whatever, Lord, you have given us all things, that there is no more one thing that you are yet to give us. You have given us all. We thank you and glorify your name. Oh, yes, Lord, receive all the glory. Receive all the praise. Receive all adoration. We acknowledge that you have given us all things when you gave us Christ. We thank you. We thank you, Lord. You have given us all things. Even the healing that many of us are looking for, you have already given us. Oh, mighty Lord, you have already given us. When you gave us Jesus, thank you, Lord. You have already given us our healing. Oh, yes, we thank you tonight. We thank you tonight because you have already released the healing of somebody that is still looking forward for healing. You have already given us. You have already given us. The kingdom prosperity. Oh, yes. We acknowledge you have given us because you have already given us. Jesus, we are so grateful. We are so grateful. We are so grateful. Oh, Shanda Bakala Bakaya. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We lack nothing. Even the peace somebody is looking for, you have given us that peace. Because when you gave us Jesus, you gave us the Prince of Peace. We thank you. The breakthrough somebody's looking for, the new job somebody's looking for, the new lifting somebody's looking for, the breakthrough someone is looking for, we acknowledge you have already given us. We are so grateful. We are so grateful, oh God. Thank you, Lord, you have given us all things. When you gave us Jesus, you gave us all. We are grateful. Oh, hallelujah. Wamene fo wako wakamine tunakuabudu.
unasema leo uaminifu wako
He has given us all things, whatever you're looking for, the month of November. You see, God does not wait to see, or let me put it this way, God does not wait to read the headlines. You see, there are many businesses in the world. To know the next course of direction, they must wait to read the world headlines. But God does not wait for that. God does not wait for that. He has already visited every day the month of November. I wish you can hear that. God is not waiting to see what the day or tomorrow shall bring. He has already visited every day the month of November. And he has already packaged every day with the blessings, with the breakthroughs, with the provisions. But many times we are the ones who do not see. Therefore, the greatest prayer you can make for your life is, oh Lord, open thou mine eyes that I may see what you have prepared for me. May we have our eyes open to see the blessings the month of November. I have no doubt there are blessings for you the month of November. Oh yes. And you know what he said in Jeremiah 33, verse 3. Call unto me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. So every time you call him, no matter what you had known before, you will know something. That is, he will show you. And the moment you see what he is showing you, then you can possess what he is showing you. So we're going to make that prayer as we thank him for the Holy Spirit and the things that he has already prepared for us. I trust that you believe that the month of November is loaded. It's not empty. And for your information, the month of November 2020 is not a repetition. It's not a repeat pattern of another year. Yes, the world headlines may be threatening. Our national news may be so disturbing. But our God is not changed. If you can dare believe him, your experience will be different. So we are making acknowledgement. Lord, you have already visited November. And every day is loaded with wonderful, great things. Now our eyes be open. We thank you for those things. Now, Lord, open our eyes that we may see those things. Please, in a moment, before we close, just lift up your hands. Thank God that he has visited every day the month of November. Oh, yes. And every day is loaded. Is every loaded with the blessings of God. No matter what we may have gone through, no matter the experiences of October, no matter the experiences of all the months, all the months down to the month of January, the month of November is loaded with good. Ye katabayata kaya, reko soko tapalada kaya. We thank you, Lord, that you have visited the month of November. Every day is the day you have made. Every day is a great day. We thank you, Lord. Now, Lord, let our eyes be open. Our eyes be open to see the blessings of November, to see the breakthroughs of November, to see the liftings of November, to see the favor of November. Oh, mighty God, we thank you and glorify your name.
Wa minifu wako, wa kamilele. Tuinue mikono mahali popote tulipo tumwambie tena.
Waaminifu wako wakaa milele, tunakuabudu wewe ni.
Tuinue mikono yote miwili mahali popote ulipo tumwambie tena.
Waaminifu wako
tumwambie tena mara nyingine, waaminifu wake wakaa milele.
Waaminifu wake wakaa milele, tunakuabudu wewe ni Mungu.
Let's give the Lord a mighty hand of praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Those that are in the sanctuary, please, you may take your seats. Just get a seat somewhere. And those that are with us on radio, and those that are with us on Facebook, we thank God for joining us in this first day of the prayer week. This is our prayer week, and today we focused on thanksgiving. And we shall continue tomorrow. I want to make a special invitation to all of us, even though you are not a member of JJV. Tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, we shall have 3 days of prayer and fasting. So I am inviting every one of you that you are going to join us. You can fast from 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening. However, you may take water. And as much as you are comfortable, but you can press yourself, inconvenience yourself in some way, and let us just have the 3 days as special days of prayer and fasting as we receive all the more and as we command the month of November. Now, you cannot just wait to see what will happen. And these things, if you are born again Christian, you don't just wish, you see, all the prophecies that have been made over your life, they must be made to come to pass by prayer. Every time you hear the word of God, it is a call to pray. Every time you hear the word of God, it is a call for prayer. You remember Elijah, after 3.5 years of no rain, and famine was everywhere. The situation was so difficult. Then when he came back after 3.5 years, he did not just prophesy. So after 3.5 years, Elijah did not only prophesy rain. After he prophesied rain, he did not go to the next restaurant to eat and fill his stomach. He went to fast. After he prophesied, he went to fast and he went for prayer and he put his head between his legs and called upon the name of the Lord and called upon the name of the Lord. Every time you hear a prophecy, for example, the declarations we receive from our pulpits, the man of God has declared something. When the man of God declares something to you and then you receive by saying, amen. After you have shouted the loudest amen, now know that you should go and put your head between your feet. What I'm only saying is that go and pray. You actualize the prophecies by prayer. It was said yesterday, the man of God declared over my life, the Lord has spoken to me this way. Then you effect it in prayer. That's why what God has said for us the month of November must be made to come to pass by our positioning in prayer and fasting. So, wherever you are, those that will be able to join us here physically, you're most welcome. And tomorrow we have a physical morning service. It is not going to be streamed either on radio or Facebook in the morning from 6:30 to 7:45 in the morning. Physically, we are going to be here physically. You will only come with your mask. wash your hands, then enter and pray and pray, and that will be wonderful. The same way, lunch our service tomorrow or the way to Friday from 12:30 at noon p.m. and then to 1:45, we shall be here physical. We shall not be streaming the morning service and the lunch hour service. We shall not be streaming in any way. But in the evening tomorrow, we shall continue on this live stream. Wale ambao natusikiza kwa radio, remember that this is a live service. I'm right now on the pulpit. It's not a recorded message. You are now hearing hot, but it is hot, and it is wonderful. So join us now for these 3 days, tomorrow to Friday. It's not really a lot. It is doable. Many of us can do that. It's going to be awesome. Want also to let us know that the month of November has been declared by the leading of the Spirit as our season of empowerment for kingdom prosperity. That is to say, God is speaking to us kingdom prosperity. We will keep teaching as He's leading us, and we'll keep on declaring, and we are so happy that we are receiving so many testimonies. Thank you so much. For those that are with us on Facebook and you are sharing, it's a blessing. We thank God for you. Thank you for those that were able to be with us on the Facebook. We appreciate you, and we thank God for you. Tomorrow shall be great. Please join us for the prayer and fasting tomorrow. And those that can join us here in Meru, you are most welcome these 3 days. Tomorrow morning from 6:30 to 7:45, you are welcome to be physically in church. You just need to have a mask, then just come. And then we shall have a moment of praying together. The same case with the lunch hour. And then in the evening, we shall also come physically. But if you, by whatever reason, you are not able to come, you can actually follow online, both on GGV FM 97.1, Mount Kenya region, the Upper Eastern, and also on Facebook. Thank you so much. God bless you and have a great time until we come your way. November shall be a blessing to you. November, you shall live and not die. God be with you.